VOAD are organizations that we work with. We've been especially working very closely and collaboratively with the VOADs group since the disaster back starting on October 4th. And what VOAD stands for is a volunteer organization active during disasters. And they're actually registered with the state. They come in and they go through a registration process with the state. And a typical VOAD, example of VOAD would be, for example, the Red Cross, Salvation Army, St. Bernard's Project, Methodist men's organizations, groups like that come in, and what they do is amazing, is they respond countrywide around the entire country to disasters, and they bring in large groups of volunteers, and they actually help people get their lives put back together. We have VOADs working in conjunction with contractors on these homes to try to get people back in their home, try to get people's lives back to where they have a safe, sound, and secure home to live in.
What we're currently doing now is we are the lead for the Midlands Flood Recovery Group, which is the long-term recovery coordination of the different nonprofit groups called VOADs that come in to do rebuild work. We're also coordinating with groups that are doing case management, volunteer management of the wonderful volunteers that want to come into our community to help us do projects, and also coordinating with local funders to make sure that we can maximize use of the resources. So we have some wonderful out-of-state groups that are helping us, like St. Bernard Project that was born out of Katrina. They have an amazing operation and they've set up root here in South Carolina to help us recover. Some of our local partners that were partners here and have developed even stronger partnerships with us since is Habitat for Humanity and Homeworks.
Activity-wise, we got here in October. Within about a month, we were rebuilding, owner-occupied rebuilds, doing right now about four at a time. And I would say that we always like to say we're here for the long haul. We're gonna stay here until we feel like South Carolina's back on its feet, and that may be a year, maybe 2 years, but we're working hard to make it as quickly as possible.
Roof damage, we're seeing crawl space damage. Something most people know that we're addressing is mold remediation. There's a great need for the treatment of the mold that is infesting the houses. When the flood came, not only did it just actually flood houses, but it flooded their crawl spaces and their attics, and that led to a surge of mold in these houses, which is really unhealthy for the families.
When the flooding hit, we were in a place where we'd been building our capacity to have more construction staff so that we could do more things, which we were already kind of positioned then for the changes that would come. What we decided to do is that we would do flood rebuild work in conjunction with our typical model of repairs, which is smaller safety sanitation repairs for elderly, disabled, low-income homeowners. So our goal this year in 2016 is to do 90 of those typical homeworks projects that are one day, couple day long blitz projects, as well as up to 10 is our hope, 10 full flood rebuilds that we know would take 1 month, 2 months to do a full rebuild of a house that's been damaged.
Just to hear them say that Hearts and Hands or St. Bernard Project has contacted them and they've given them the required info is really a great feeling. We believe whenever the funds become available, it's really a good chance that these residents will get their needs met and be on the road to recovery.
So we know our nonprofits have wait lists that are very, very long and they're struggling to meet those needs and do work as quickly as they can. So definitely supporting our VOADs, our nonprofits that are doing that rebuild work, attracting additional nonprofits to our community from out of state or other areas that could help us speed up and increase that capacity, and then resources. Frankly, we're 6 months out, so this is not on the front page anymore. People have forgotten, people have moved on, and we have people in real need, and we need to raise resources so that we can make sure that our VOADs and others can continue their work.
The best thing we can ask for is volunteers, right? So as we get longer and longer from the disaster, things are starting to fall out of the media's eye. People forget that people are out of their home. They're stuck in trailers or in a home that's actually not livable anymore. And because it's been wiped off the street, people don't realize that it's still a very sincere problem, not even in the Midlands, but across the state of South Carolina. So volunteering, while we have volunteers now, those numbers and that volunteer is gonna start to diminish as we get farther from the flooding. So really establishing volunteering with us now will help us be more sustainable in the long run.
We are continually in need, especially around the Midlands area, for what we'll call flood rebuild volunteers. Folks that can come for a one-day shift here or there, Today we have corporate employees working, and it's so important and special for us to have volunteers that can work during the week. That enables us to not just go Saturday to Saturday, it allows us to continue to move the projects forward. So that'd be one big thing that we need is week-time volunteers in the Midlands area.
We would love for anyone to get involved, so individuals or groups, church groups. You can go to our website at uway.org, and there's a whole flood recovery page there. You can get information on our long-term recovery groups. You can see how we're coordinating work and who's involved. You can get information if you want to volunteer. If you need help, there's a link to 211, which is our main portal that we're encouraging everybody to call if you have any type of need from flood or storm damage.
Through all of this, the long-term recovery group is doing everything they can to help our residents recover from the flood and get back to a normal life as they once knew it.
We want our citizens to be in a safe, secure, and sanitary home. And that's our goal right now. And right now, we've identified over 215 homes that we hope to be able to affect in the next few months to get our citizens back to as near normal as possible.